Brisbane teenager has claimed she was kicked off a public bus because her disability requires her to use a mobility scooter. 15-year-old Paige Caruana was just minutes into a bus ride when the driver asked her to get off or leave her scooter behind, claiming the battery wasn't safe. Paige's mum immediately complained to TransLink, believing the driver's actions were unlawful.
Well, Paige and her mum Kylie are here with us now. Paige, tell us what happened after you first got on that bus.
It was Boxing Day and I was going back from Macrobat to Canada because we wanted to see like any more deals that we could find. But we had issues on the bus. There was a young man that got off halfway through the bus ride, and then the bus driver came up to me and asked me, is that a scooter? I said yes. Then he said if you can either take the scooter off the bus or like get off the bus with the scooter.
So how did that make you feel when the bus driver wouldn't let you ride on there?
Well, it made me feel like very upset. Like it took away almost my independence and yeah.
Paige, you were pretty much left on the side of the road with a storm coming. That must have been really scary.
It was. I was getting soaked and this young man that got off at the bus stop that we were kicked off at, he was like staying with us to make sure we were safe and like helping us not get wet from the rain.
Kylie, what was it like to get that call from your daughter?
I was actually horrified, and initially I thought she was kidding me when she rang and said, you're not going to believe what's just happened to us, we've been kicked off a bus. And I knew how far away she was, so I obviously dropped everything and just raced to her aid. It took me half an hour to get there. Yeah, when I got there, she was cold, wet, embarrassed, and just, I think, grateful to see me.
Yes, I was.
What do you think of the way your daughter was treated?
I'm horrified, mortified. It's just, I don't know how anyone can fathom that a mobility scooter is not safe to be on a bus. Even if the bus driver did receive a message about perhaps a scooter battery not being allowed on the bus and his instructions were to, you know, not let any scooters on the bus, then perhaps make some better decisions. Drop her off at a safe location, let her go to her destination, not just leave her stranded in the on the side of the road, because it could have been so much worse.
I understand that you've had a conversation today with the Transport Minister. What came of that? Was there any explanation provided?
Well, I have missed a call from Ryan. I haven't actually spoken to him yet because I think we're playing a bit of phone tag. But I want to make sure that it doesn't happen to Paige or anyone in Paige's situation in the future. Like, Paige is fortunate enough to be able to rely on her parents to take her from A to B if she doesn't want to use public transport. But there are so many people out there in our community that don't have that luxury and need public transport to get around. They provide wheelchair access on all buses. Why is it okay for one person to take away that basic human right for someone to get around? It's just not okay, and we need to make sure that this doesn't happen to Paige or anyone else in the future.
Paige, Kylie, thanks so much for your time tonight. I think I can hear the phone in the background. It might be the Transport Minister, so we'll let you go.
No worries, guys. Thank you.
Bye.
Excuse me. I've got something caught in my throat.
I'll go on. Now, in a statement, Brisbane City Council said it is taking the matter seriously and working with TransLink to ensure all policies and procedures are understood by drivers.